And thank you so much for joining us tonight at 6. I'm Julie Montanaro.
And I'm Jacob Murphy.
The Eyewitness News team has been on the ground across the Big Bend since before sunup, talking with people about the impact of this storm. Abrea Ruffin and Savannah Kelly are live in Taylor County, where the hurricane made landfall this morning.
And we begin with Stacy Inez in Suwanee County, where people there are feeling rising flood water. Stacy, what are you seeing?
Absolutely. Jacob, Julie, you said it there. People are just in shock, really. People tell me that they have never seen anything like this in this neighborhood. We're in the Terra Trace neighborhood off of County Road 136, and you can just look behind me and see how high those waters are, and you can see those waters are moving as well. This is what has sent some neighbors in a panic, and this is also what prompted the elderly man to be rescued from his home. Take a look. Escaping rapidly rising floodwaters, this elderly man was rescued from his live oak home as the neighborhood goes underwater.
Over the last couple hours, it's just started to get worse and worse. Obviously, it's progressing.
AJ Stevens was one of the men in this video. He says his elderly uncle is bedridden and they needed to get him out to safety.
We wanted to get him out before the water got too bad and he was stuck. So we were carrying him out from the building and getting him to a car where they have another house and they can go ahead and get him squared away and in a better, more comfortable position without all the water.
Neighbors working quickly to help each other with only moments to spare.
Started to rise, and in like 2 hours, it was from the tire to the windows. So happened pretty swiftly.
Madeline Gamble says that's when panic started settling in.
The water got so high, it blew the transformer right in front of our house. So that was a little scary.
She and Brittany Shearer say they've never seen their neighborhood in this condition.
This is an elderly neighborhood, so we're probably the youngest people that live here, which is great because we can get out and help them, but scary nonetheless because a lot of them don't have places to go.
As for rescues, Stevens and a few others then took their canoes going door to door to look for more people who need to escape.
Once there's nowhere for the water to go, the only place it's going to end up is in your living room and on your porch. So we wanted to get them out before it got too bad.
Now, just in the last 30 minutes or so, we've seen the Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission, along with the National Guard, on their high water ATVs. They've been going through this neighborhood just to see if there's anyone else that needs any help. We also did get in touch with Sheriff St. John here in Suwanee County, and that he says there's been several water rescues today, and he even had to help rescue a man from his car as well. So a lot going on in this area, but of course, we'll continue to keep you updated as these floodwaters continue from here in Suwanee County. For now, Julie and Jacob, I'll send it back to you.
Yeah, it's incredible to see how quickly that water is rising there, Stacy, and I'm so thankful for all those neighbors that jumped in to help. Thank you.